They out there panicking right now. I can feel it. They out there. They're panicking. Look at them.
Now, you're not naive enough to think we're living in a democracy, are you, buddy? It's the free market. And you're part of it.
What's happening? What's happening? What's happening? Shout out to all those beginner investors and traders out there. I hope you had a great weekend. Now we are back. This is Hood Money Investing. You done pulled up to the block market. I wanted to take some time to show you beginner investors and traders out there my portfolio, because for the last couple of weeks, I've been tied up in some other things. I told y'all I was going to be putting the eBay channel on here, the Poshmark channel on here, show you different ways that I am flipping my money, investing my money, and that's one of the ways. And you can check that out on the channel if you get an opportunity to. I got some more things that I'm learning, and I plan on showing you beginner investors and traders out there like myself. But I wanted to take some time to show you the portfolio, because we have some funny things going on right now in Robinhood, so you have to stay up on this. Right now we have an NNDM play that we have till February, and for some odd apparent reason, this is constantly happening on Robinhood. Now that I'm recording, so now the game is going to disappear again. So this is what's happening, you know what I mean? These are little things that happens in Robinhood. And in my opinion, this is just another way for them to scalp money off the top from clients, which is completely BS. Okay, and now right there, you can see it pop back. So I advise you, beginner investors and traders out there, if you're going to be on Robinhood, make sure that you keep record of your portfolio. And if you're going to decide to put lots of money into a brokerage firm, I would advise you to look into a firm that's a little bit more reputable, a firm that you can contact at any time. You know, they have TD Ameritrade, they have Fidelity, Charles and Schwab's. It's just a few other reputable brokerages that you can check out before jumping into Robinhood. Robinhood just has a clean app. It's user friendly, beginner friendly, and a lot of people use it because you can explain things very easily while going through the app and taking your time pointing out different things that help different beginner investors and traders, or just traders and investors just helping explain different things. So right now, you know, like I said, I wanted to take some time to show you the portfolio because I've been into some other things trying to increase my profits in other ways, you know, and I wanted to show you this portfolio because I told you, you know, we're doing this together. As you can see, I got some plays, I got some veil plays that I made. I should have honestly made more because of the research that I've been doing on veil, which has not been very detailing. It's just been enough for me to understand, based on the psychology and the fear of people missing out with the EV market and the electric. Well, you know, that feel right there, I just think that it's going to blow. You know, if you check out Piedmont Lithium, like I said, and when they happen to do their deal with Tesla, their stock increased. It doubled, I think, almost triple, if I'm not mistaken. Okay. And right now people have an understanding that Vale is a mining company and they mine for different minerals and resources. And there are resources that they are mining that are going to be used for electric vehicles. And I understand that, you know, so that right there gave me an opportunity for maybe a month and a half to kind of scalp off of Vail and just keep constantly doing it. And that's what I've been doing for about a month and a half with Vail. I took this, this right here is a gap play. And I did a little bit of research, but I came across Chris Slane video. I think that's his name. Excuse me if I got it wrong. This brother has some great information. You guys might want to go check him out as well. And I think this is a play that he mentioned, if I'm not mistaken. If he didn't, I want you guys to make sure you look into his page because he has some great plays, so I can be mistaken. But I'm pretty sure I got this from him, and I just wanted to see, based on all the information that I was hearing about him, all the good things. That's all I've been hearing is positive things about this brother. He's an awesome trader, awesome investor. From my own personal views, okay. I've checked out his page and I've listened to some of his plays. Some of the plays I've already made, some plays he turned me on to as far as some pharmaceutical plays. I think it was a couple other, but right off the top, I can't think about it. But I think you guys should go check him out then. His brother has a lot of good information. So that's one of the reasons why I made that play. And at the moment now, when I make plays, I'm not really worried too much because I'm not just making them blind anymore, looking for, you know, a quick profit. That's not what I'm doing. That's the reason why you can see a lot of these plays I've had for a very long time. A lot of these plays are about to expire, but I've made a few dollars off of them. And that's when, you know, you can see yourself making that 50 or 100 plus a week if you look at one company or two companies and you really pay attention to how that company fluctuates, pay attention to the news that's surrounding it, the hype that's surrounding it, and then you have to pay attention to the players, you know, and you can't forget about the algorithm. And that's the reason why we go long in Robinhood. You know, that gives us an opportunity to take away the advantage from the people behind it that's using our money to buy stocks or make plays and profit or even bet against us. You see what I'm saying? So when you take these long plays 2-3 months out the way, it gives you an opportunity to generate profit on plays that you've educated yourself on and informed yourself on. And then that way you can accumulate that profit. And just because it's 2 months out does not mean I should hold it for 2 months. You know what I'm saying? You have to make smart decisions based on the market and what you feel, you know. And I have to say this, something is better than nothing. So, you know, say if a stock is at 10 bucks and it goes up to 5 and you only thought it was going to go up to 13, I think you might want to take profit. If you take profit and it goes up to 20, I wouldn't say be upset, but the smartest thing to do would probably be to take profits and then, you know, buy back in. You see what I'm saying? Instead of making a bad play, which I've done that before with GameStop, and then the stock stops and it drops and then you lose that profit. You see? So I'm still learning and doing my best to educate myself on the stocks and do my best to bring you beginner investors and traders like myself good ideas so you can make smarter decisions because I want you to skip over all the mistakes I've made, you know, pretty much. So these are the plays right now that I'm looking at, checking out. I got GameStop, I got NMDM. I got to jump in more on that. We got Fuel Cell Energy, Ocean Power Technology. I think that is a stock that you need to jump on right now. You don't hear nobody talking about this stock. I've been talking about it for months now, but since I'm a beginner trader and investor, you might not hear too much about, you know, this until somebody that's a little bit more reputable in the YouTube subscribers' eyes, they might go to that person. But I've been talking about Ocean Power Technologies for a while now, and I just really believe in the tech. And I can see the future as far as where we're going. Technology is getting so advanced. I think this is going to cause the what we see as rich or wealthy, common, you know, rich or wealthy person is just, we're going to see a change. I think this is when we're going to see this video game life that people are going to be living, this universal or Star Wars, Guardians of the Galaxy type of living, you know what I mean? With units and credits and stuff like that, where you're going to see people accumulating hundreds of millions of dollars and billions of dollars, because cryptocurrency is going to give people the opportunity to accumulate just unbelievable amounts of money, you know. And the way that they're changing over to a digital system and the way that they're using technology, this is going to be a way for people to, like, you're going to start seeing vehicles and stuff that's going to cost $100 million, $200 million, you know, $1 billion, a spaceship, $1 billion, stuff like that. This is what you're going to start seeing in the new world. You know, this is the reason why that they have the pandemic and all this stuff going on, because they don't want you to be up on this Star Trek futuristic future that we're about to come into. And a lot of people, they're going to miss it, not being involved in cryptocurrency and understanding what's going on as far as the technological advancements and digital advancements, the quantum upgrades that we're going to witness in the system. And it's just a lot of things going on right now. And I don't want to, you know, ramble and blow you guys' heads off with this stuff, but I just think Ocean Power Technologies is involved with the tech. It's leading as far as with potential. It's number one in this field. They make batteries, if I'm not mistaken, generators, buoys for powering boats and using them as lights so that people know where they're going, or, you know, so they like sort of like GPS, help them with destination and stuff like that. But it's, you know, and I'm just rambling at the moment, because these are things that I'm just, first of all, I already know. I grew up, you know, kind of above and beyond, like, as far as the future is Star Trek. And I mean, I was watching Dragon Ball Z 30 years ago, you know what I mean, before people knew what it was, you know. So when it comes to anime and it comes to technology and it comes to just the things that people aren't paying attention to and just can't see it till it's too late, I've pretty much been before my time, you know, just as well as me being before my time now. And then I know exactly what it's going to be. Not exactly, not 100%, but in my mind, we're going to be, you know, living sort of not like the Jetsons, flying all around and living in the sky and stuff. But I mean, I wouldn't say that's far-fetched. I mean, we've seen the Avengers and how they have, you know, technology of machinery that can float in the air, you know, and stuff like that. I mean, we've seen cartoons, we've seen, you know, we know they're trying to get to space. They are in space. They are, you know, they from what I've read, you know, there are stations on Mars and, you know, the moon and here and there. And I'm a believer, you know. I mean, my mind is pretty much all the way out the box. So these are some of the reasons why I can see these technological advancements putting people in a position where you're going to see the average millionaire or billionaire get blown out the water. Like, this is going to be, you know, the time when you'll see tycoons just popping up out of nowhere. Just people that you wouldn't even believe, just because of technology and their ability to use it and understanding of it. You know what I'm saying? So that's one of the reasons why I think you guys should jump into Ocean Power Technologies, check it out, and make some smart decisions around technology too. Just because people are hyped about it and they're telling you that you should be hyped about it, it doesn't necessarily mean that that particular stock is going to boom, because some of these people are being paid to advertise these stocks. You know, me personally, I'm just an average, you know, beginner, from the bottom, you know, from nothing, trader, investor, beginner that's trying to find different ways to make money and increase my funds and potentially reach financial freedom. I'm just like you. You know what I'm saying? So, and that's why I do this research, and I'm telling you to be careful, because you're not dealing with just, you know, the stock, you're dealing with the broker, you're dealing with the algorithm, you're dealing with shady practices taking place behind these beginner brokerage firms and stuff like that. And you're dealing with inside trading. It's so much that you're dealing with that you have to really, you know, take your time when it comes to trading and investing in stocks. Now, when you're buying stocks, you're great. You're in a great position, you know, but when you're trading, that's when you have to worry when you're dealing with these sites that aren't as reputable as the ones that have been around for decades, you know. That's what I want to talk to you guys. I wanted to talk to you guys about. The market is looking pretty good. Let's just see, is the S&P, how's the S&P looking right now? It's down, let's see. 1%, so that's not too bad. With the stimulus checks package in the, it looks as if it's about to get signed. I mean, we might get some good news, then all of a sudden, boom, the market could just take off. So, you know, that's pretty much what I'm waiting for, man. My patience is just turning into a lion in the grassy knoll in the Serengeti in the desert, just sitting there waiting. Our fangs just salivating, just waiting to attack. You know what I'm saying? So that's all we doing right now, man. Just waiting. Veil looking good. Look, it was up to 1730, I think. Let's check. It got up to like 17 something. Oh, 1744. It was 1744 on the 18th. I see. Oh, and it was looking very good, very good. Vels could double. It could possibly double within the next 2 months. You know what I mean? I'm telling y'all to jump on this Sasol. It's definitely going boom. The pandemic is holding this stock down. I don't have it. I bought a few, but I'm waiting, you know, but this is definitely a play. I think, you know, you beginner investors and traders might want to check out. Remember, I'm not an investing guru. I'm not a financial advisor. So please don't make any of the plays that, you know, I make based on the decisions that I'm making. You know, please do your own research, do your own reconnaissance, get out there on the block, make sure you're watching out for the cops, the jakes, the snitches, and all them out there trying to take your riches. You know what I'm saying? And do your due diligence. But that's what I advise. Just check it out. NMD, we all know that stock is going to do great. 3D printing and the other applications that are used for this is just unbelievable, and this stock is just waiting to explode. Sunwork, as you can see, a lot of these on my ticker are just stocks that I just periodically piece through. I shorten my positions as well. As you can see, you go and check out my page in the beginning, you can see I had much more positions, but I had to shorten them. ETH is up, man. Doge was up to like 50, 0.0051, something like that. I wouldn't be surprised if Dogecoin went to like 50 cents. Like in like a year or two. I wouldn't be surprised if it did it before that, but you know, we'll see. So yeah, as you can see, we have we don't count the Zoom. I doubled up on that play before it did what it did. I put about $50 into it when it was down about $200, and it jumped up to $4 something, $5, and I was just like taking bits and pieces off of it, like 20 here, 20 here. And I think I ended up making like a buck. I think it was like a buck off of it, a little bit over $100, but it was worth it. Let's see. This right here, BioKey, is definitely a company you might want to check out. I think this might be one of those stocks that in the future a lot of people are going to be talking about. AMS. This is a company, they deal in medical field, excuse me. As you can see, America Share Hospital Services engages in leasing and radio surgery and radiation therapy equipment to healthcare providers. Its equipment includes gamma knife, beat, PBRT and IGRT, the Gamma Knife Radio Surgery Equipment, is a non-invasive treatment for malignant and benign brain tumors, vascular malformations, and trigeminal neuralgias. Excuse me for butchering that word. The company was founded by Ernest A. Bates in 1977. This is the stock that they call the black-owned company stock. It's on the stock market, man. And so that's all they see is green. That's all I want to say. Plug is definitely doing this thing. I wish I had. I'm still smacking myself about Plug. I had about 30, 35, between 30 and 40 shares, which I should have kept. But I'm thinking about honestly just dumping all the stock and putting it into Fuel Cell Energy. But I haven't made up my mind yet because it's a possibility that Plug's gonna go to like $100 or at least get close to it. So I'm just trying to weigh it out right now. Got ARK. I'm definitely should have been jumping into it more. But I've been just into other things right now. I gotta dig more deeper because I don't know what Kathy Woods is doing, and I'm trying to make the right decision based on the moves that she is going to make, you know, because of the stake that, oh man, I forget the name of the, I believe it's a company or that has 51% stake in her, ARK Invest, or a little higher if I'm not mistaken, and they plan on, there's something going on between ARK Invest and this other company, Kathy Wood, I guess. I'm not sure about ARK Invest, but it's been running up, you know, for the last month, maybe. Neo, still waiting to see what it's gonna do. Gevo is definitely a company I think you guys might wanna check out. They produce like biofuel, you know, an alternative to gasoline. I think you might want to check that out. And that's pretty much it. You know, I told you guys I was going to jump back on my portfolio, show you what's going on. Check out this NMD. What are they doing? Okay. Is they playing around? You know, Robinhood does a lot of playing around. And I told you guys, see that drop all of a sudden? And it's just Robinhood has a lot of BS with it. But you got to stay on it as well, you know, and make sure that you, like I said, document everything that's going on in your portfolio, if that's possible, if you have the means. I want to, again, say I hope all you beginner investors and traders had a great weekend. This is Hood Money Investing. Please check me out on Instagram, Hood Money Investing. That's Hood Money _ Investing. Check us out on YouTube. Please subscribe. I will subscribe back if you're a beginner investor and trader out there. Let's make this money together. Let's educate ourselves together. Let's inform ourselves together. If you have any tricks, strategies, tips, anything for us when we going in the game or when we in this huddle, please leave it down in the comment box. Everybody that's left a comment, I appreciate it. Everybody that's took their time to watch a video, I appreciate it. And once again, don't forget to check out Veil and check out Ocean Power Technologies, please. Once again, this is Hood Money Investing. You've pulled up to the block market. If you thinking this is Wall Street, guess what? You done made the wrong turn. This is Hood Money Investing. And I want to say, get this money to all my Hood Money hustlers.
They out there panicking right now. I can feel it. They out there. They're panicking. Look at them.
Now, you're not naive enough to think we're living in a democracy, are you, buddy? It's the free market. And you're part of it.
Something just came across my desk, John. It is perhaps the best thing I've seen in the last 6 months. If you have 60 seconds, I'd like to share the idea with you. You got a minute?
After everything we've done for you.
Oh, see, I made Lewis a bet here. Lewis bet me that we couldn't both get rich and put y'all in the poorhouse at the same time. He didn't think we could do it. I won.
I lost. $1.
Thank you, Lewis.
After you.
Certainly.